Hello students, welcome to e-classes of P.N. Amarse High School. We will continue with our chapter number 12, Ratio and Proportion.
Now let us continue with our exercise 12.1. Students, here is a mistake in your textbook. Instead of this question number 14, you cut it and write it as question number 13. Now question number 13 is divide 20 pens between Sheila and Sangeeta in the ratio of 3:2. Question number 13 is this much. Now solution for sum number 13. Here first we have to find out total equal parts. To find out the total equal parts, we will add 3 plus 2, which is given in the question as 3:2. In the place of 3:2, we will write here 3 plus 2, that is 5. Now the total equal parts are 5. Out of 5 equal parts, Sheila gets 3 parts and Sangeeta gets 2 parts. Here in the question it's written, we have to divide the pans between Sheila and Sangeeta in the ratio of 3:2. So Sheila gets 3 parts and Sangeeta gets 2 parts. Now out of 20 pens, it's also given in the question that we have to divide 20 pens between Sheila and Sangeeta. So out of 20 pens, Sheila's share is equals to 3 upon 5 multiplied by 20. Here as Sheila gets 3 parts out of 5 equal parts, we will write it as 3 upon 5 multiplied by total number of pens, that is 20. So if we multiply 3 and 20, we will get 60, and 60 divided by 5. So 60 divided by 5 is 12. So Sheila's share is 12. Next we have to find out Sangeeta's share. Now Sangeeta gets 2 parts out of 5 total parts. So 2 by 5 multiplied by 20. Now 20 is total number of pens. So first we will multiply this 2 by 20. 2 multiplied by 20 is 40 divided by 5. So 40 divided by 5 is 8. Therefore the answer is Sheila gets 12 pens and Sangeeta gets 8 pens. And if we add 12 plus 8, we will get the total as 20. That was given in the question that we have to divide 20 pens between Sheila and Sangeeta. So Sheila gets 12 pens and Sangeeta gets 8 pens. Now students, do one more correction. In the place of question number 13, cut it and write it question number 14. Consider the statement, ratio of breadth and length of a hall is 2:5. Complete the following table that shows some possible breadth and length of the hall. And this table belongs to question number 14. We have to fill this table and we have to consider the ratio of breadth and length of a hall as 2:5. Now solution for sum number 14 here. A table is given where breadth of the hall in meters and length of the hall in meters are given. We have to fill this empty spaces. Here if the breadth of the hall is 10 meters and the length of the hall is 25 meters. And here if the length of the hall is 50 meters, we have to find out the breadth of the hall. And if the breadth of the hall is 40 meters, we have to find out the length of the hall. And we have to consider the ratio of breadth and length of a hall as 2:5, which is given in the question. Now in the second column, let the breadth be x meters. Here in the second column, we don't have the breadth of the hall. So we will consider it as x meters and length of the hall is 50 meters. Now the ratio of the breadth to the length is 2:5, it's given in the question. So here we will write it as x upon 50. Here x is breadth of the hall and 50 is length of the hall, is equals to 2:5, which is given in the question. And here 2 is also breadth of the hall and 5 is length of the hall. Now we will use cross multiplication method. So we will multiply this 5 by x. So here we will write 5 multiplied by x and we will multiply 50 and 2. So here we will write 2 multiplied by 50. So 5 multiplied by x is equals to 2 multiplied by 50. Now here first we will find out 5 multiplied by x and 2 multiplied by 50. 5 multiplied by x is 5x and 2 multiplied by 50 is 100. And To find out the value of x, we will write here x as it is and we will divide this 100 by 5. So 100 divided by 5. Now 5 1 is 5 and 5 20 is 100. So value of x is 20. Therefore breadth of the hall is 20 meter. Now in the table we will write the breadth of the hall as 20 meters. Now in the third column you can see here the breadth of the hall in meters is 40 and we don't have the length of the hall, so we will consider it as y. So here in the third column let the length be y meters. Now 40 upon y, 40 is breadth of the hall and y is length of the hall, is equals to 2 ratio 5, that is 2 upon 5. Here 2 is the breadth of the hall and 5 is the length of the hall. Again we will use cross multiplication method. We will multiply this 40 and 5 and we will write here as 40 multiplied by 5 equals to y multiplied by 2. So here we will write 2 multiplied by y. So by multiplying 40 and 5 we will get 200 is equals to 2y is 2y. Now we will find out the value of y, so we will write y here and we will divide this 200 by 2. So y is equal to 200 divided by 2. By dividing 200 by 2 we will get y as 100. Therefore the length of the hall is 100 meters. So in the table we will write it as 100 meters length of the hall. So in this way you have to complete this table. Students, with this we end our today's video and we will continue with our chapter in the next video. Thank you.